Welcome to KPassionate.
I'm your host, KP, a marine biologist with over a decade's worth of experience working with marine mammals. Recently, we took a deeper dive into how I'm training Joey, the world-famous sea otter, how to spin. And if you missed it, you can catch that video right up here. If you're a fan of this channel or you watch my live stream over on my Twitch channel, you may be aware that Joey the sea otter is not an ambi-turner.
Good! I think he can only spin to the left.
Which has everyone asking, can animals be left or right pawed?
Wow, perfect.
You guys, go this way. There we go.
So today, we're going to take a deeper dive and try to answer that question. But first, don't forget to like, subscribe, and head on over to my Twitch channel. You can catch live streams and ask me your questions live. But before we go any further, many people have been asking me why I'm even teaching him to spin in the first place. And this is a valid question. The short answer is that learning something new is great for the brain. The sea otters under my care live very easy lives. They don't have to hunt for food, and they don't have to worry about being hunted. So that eliminates a lot of the things that would normally give them mental stimulation out in the dangerous ocean. But mental stimulation is still important. And that is part of the reason that we train new behaviors. They might look silly to you, but they actually serve a really important purpose of keeping the mind and the body engaged. If you want to learn more about how and why we train, you can check out my old video up here. So let's start talking about Joey's spin behavior. When we teach an animal to do these types of behaviors, we usually train them to go in both directions.
Good. Spin. Good.
Each direction or each behavior will have a unique hand signal. So in this case, for a spin, to spin to the left, we ask it with our left hand. To spin to the right, we ask with our right hand. Usually, we teach the animals how to spin to the right first. And the reason for this is simple. Most of us are right-handed. Humans live in a right-handed world. I can only assume that for my left-handed viewers, this is painfully obvious. Whether it be the cup holders in your car,
the swipe for credit cards, right-handed scissors, and even the mouse for your computer. About 90% of the human population are right-hand dominant.
And for many years, scientists actually believed that handedness was a uniquely human trait. But there is a growing body of evidence to suggest that animals may have right or left flipperness. And it all likely begins in the brain.
It's something called the corpus callosum, which is the nerve tract that separates the brain into left and right hemispheres.
And it's found in all placental mammals. There are studies that have linked a high level of handedness with a smaller corpus callosum, and those with a larger corpus callosum tend to be more ambidextrous individuals. Marine mammals like sea lions, seals, and sea otters, like our friend Joey, are also placental mammals,
which is one of the three subdivisions of the mammalia class of animals.
Which means that they have a corpus callosum, and in my opinion, means that they can be right or left pawed. Quick disclaimer, the evidence that I am about to present to you is not in a scientific study, it is not peer-reviewed, it is simply my opinion and based on my experiences as a marine mammal trainer. Still, observation is a key part to science, and so I think it's worth discussing. Speaking of which, if you have a dog, a cat, or any other animal in your life that you think displays left or right-handedness, drop it in the comments below and let me know. Let's head back to Joey and how he's learning how to spin. I'm gonna show you exactly how much progress he's made, so hang in there, I promise. But first, I wanna dive a bit deeper into how he seems to be more comfortable spinning to the left. Most of the animals that I've worked with seem to have no problem spinning to the right. Take, for example, Katmai and Kunik here.
Hi, Kunik. You wanna do something? Good.
However, Mac, who is famous for his adorable food vocalizations and his easygoing nature.
Mac.
Had a similar situation like Joey. I don't have any video evidence because this was years ago, but at first, Mac could only spin to the left. That's how he learned in the first place, to the left. And you can see now, even though he can spin to the right, it looks slow and awkward.
Oh. Okay, not super great now.
I'll figure it out.
Good boy. Looks like you're good. When a professional does it. Oh, Mackie! Oh, your flips are in the way. Oh, good job, you pretty ballerina.
While this is interesting, spinning left or right may not be the best example of handedness. So what about paw or flipper taps? Let's go back to Katmai. Katmai is an extremely intelligent animal. She knows an abundance of behaviors. And one of these behaviors is a paw tap. Now you can see here, she's actually using her left paw to tap. Now, of course, we could probably teach her to tap with her right paw, but this is the way she's always done it, and she exclusively taps with her left. And this isn't unique to sea otters. Every animal that I've worked with seems to have a dominant flipper that they would rather tap with.
Good. Tappy. That one doesn't work good.
Most of the sea lions and the walruses that I worked with actually struggled to learn to tap their left flipper.
Tap. Good. It's not as good as that one, are you? Good.
They're just far more comfortable tapping their right flipper. And in fact, if you ask them for the left flipper, they still sometimes get confused and just tap both anyway. Back to sea otters, as I'm well aware that the majority of my subscribers are huge sea otter fans.
Take another look at Katmai clapping. Do you see how she only moves her left paw? And there's more.
As we know, sea otters have that very thick fur and very loose skin, especially around the armpits. These folds of extra skin form pockets that allow the sea otters to store extra items of food, mussels, clams, and even rocks. And in my experience, each sea otter seems to have a dominant pocket. A pocket in which they choose to store food more frequently than the other. But buckle your seatbelts, because I'm about to blow your mind. Remember earlier when we talked about the corpus callosum that is present in all placental mammals? What about non-placental animals, like kangaroos, possums, echidnas? Marsupials are not placental mammals, so their brains are very different. They lack that corpus callosum, meaning that their brains don't even have hemispheres. Surprisingly, a large portion of kangaroos have shown an affinity for left-handedness. This is especially apparent in red kangaroos. Even wilder, studies show that female dogs, horses, and cats tend to be right-handed, and the males of those same species, left-handed. So I think the takeaway here is that the science is still out. Scientists are still trying to figure out left and right handedness and what it means and where it comes from. While it is my opinion that animals have a dominant paw or flipper, It is not hard fact.
You can both ways, can you not? No, you're a righty. Okay, well, I mean, that's actually just the same. Well, turns out she doesn't spin the other way.
So as promised, here's your update on Joey's spin behavior. He had what I like to call the light bulb moment. He's figured out how to spin, but he can only do it to the left.
Spinning.
He can only go to the left?
That's what he's... I've only had him complete a spin to the left.
So I'm just gonna like go with it. Good!
That's okay, because learning is a process and the act of learning is really good and engaging for his brain. So I know I can teach him to spin to the right. It just might always be a little clumsy and a little awkward.
He's like, I stole it in the first place. It doesn't really matter. Good boy! Did it! Yes!
Don't forget to like and subscribe. Ask me your questions down below. And as your reward, here's that Joey spin behavior I've been talking about. Cheers.
Okay, Joe, don't let me down. Don't let me down, dude.
That was a four.
Spin. Oh, don't grunt at me. Remember? Spin. Good.
Yeah.
Joe. Good. Did you see it? Oh my God.